Hey guys, so we're doing the next video on the cognitive functions. We're looking at the synchronicity or the compatibility of the functions. We gotta lay down this foundation before we start diving into what types are compatible or incompatible with other types, as well as our virtue and vice series. So with that, we're going to be doing the synchronicity of the intuitive functions. Since I'm an intuitive, pretty relevant, but then again, this stuff is actually relevant to everybody because everyone has sensing functions and everyone has intuitive functions. It's just which functions are in their ego. So for this example, we're going to be using the INFJ and the INFP types, and we're going to be talking about their perceptual synchronicity with the intuition functions. So we have introvert intuition and extrovert intuition. Remember that introvert intuition is always connected to extroverted sensing because it's I see what you're doing and now I want to do that, or I want to give you an experience, or because you all want to go do that, I want to go do it too, or I'm doing this, you want to do it with me. You know, that's kind of how introverted sensing and extrovert intuition works. So extrovert intuition on the top, introvert intuition on the top, they're all connected to these functions. But how do extrovert intuition and introvert intuition relate to each other? So remember, introverted intuition is the personal unconscious. It is the function where you know what you want, you know what you desire, it's your willpower, your will, you know, where you're going, what you want to do, your own personal future, you're aware of your own future, not necessarily other people's futures, but your future, etc. Whereas extrovert intuition is kind of on the other side. It's everybody's willpower, everybody's desire, or the collective unconscious of man, as we know it, of all mankind, where we are going as a species, where people are going, what other people want, what other people desire, that type of thing. So when extrovert intuition looks in the future, it's like a shotgun. It goes out in different directions everywhere, and the mind is aware of all paths forward, and then it could just choose which one is the best. Whereas introvert intuition is like a sniper rifle. It cuts a path forward, one path, like a laser beam cutting through a mountain, to find its ideal path forward that it just wants to do for itself. That is extrovert intuition. What I want, willpower. Where there's a will, there's a way. Introvert intuition. Sorry if I got those a little confused there a second ago, but sorry, not sorry. Anyway, so introvert intuition, very focused like a sniper rifle, extrovert intuition like a shotgun in terms of how it's aware of the future. So now, remember, introvert intuition, because it's an introverted function, it is the source. It is a source of intuition. It is a source of desire. It is a source of willpower. And extrovert intuition users get off on that. They want to eat the introvert intuition users. So if you're in a relationship with somebody, it could be romantic, business, parenting, intimate, friend, whatever. Typically, extrovert intuition users, people who have extrovert intuition in their ego, like to hang out with introvert intuition users in their ego, because the extrovert intuition is constantly asking the introverted intuition user, hey, what do you want? Hey, what are you gonna do? Hey, what are we doing? Or what are we going to do, actually? What do we want to do, right? And the introvert intuition person is be like, well, I want to do this. And then the extrovert intuition person is like, okay, awesome, great. Another thing, introvert intuition usually always knows what it wants. Extrovert intuition seeks to give that person what they want. The extrovert intuition user is aware that this person wants a pair of new shoes. The extrovert intuition user dutifully, because it's connected to SI, it's connected to duty, the extrovert intuition user dutifully gets those shoes and gives those shoes to the NI user with what they want. And then the NI user starts wearing them. And then the SI of the extrovert intuition user has a good experience seeing that the NI user they gave those shoes is coming out with their SE because they're wearing the shoes, right? That's how this works, okay? So introvert intuition, all about what I want, all about what we want is what extrovert intuition is. Extroverted intuition wants to give introverted intuition what it wants, right? So, and it's the opposite is also true on the other side. You know, extroverted intuition users appreciate NI users because NI users are like, well, I know what I want all the time. There's no guessing, right? Nothing's left up to interpretation. The NI user can always ask the NI user what they want. And that way it's always understood, perceptually speaking. and allows for easier communication. So, and also NI users are all about freedom, because they want to have the freedom to be able to want things and exert their will, whereas NE users are very dutiful. They just like to be told by the NI user what they should do, right? Because the NI user is connected to extroverted sensing, and then the NE user is able to be like, okay, well, I should do this because that's what you want, right? That's how it works. So let's look at the INFP and the INFJ. These two types are actually super compatible with each other, probably likely highest compatibility, and they should probably be with each other. So one of the reasons why is because the INFJ walks around always knowing what they want at all times. And the INFP wants to feel secure with SI child, always wants the INFJ to think highly of them. But for the sake of this discussion, the INFP always wants to know what the INFJ wants. That way there's no guessing, because the INFP uses that as a boundary. I shouldn't do this because my INFJ lover wouldn't want me to, right? That's a form, it's kind of how loyalty forms. Because the INFP always knows what the INFJ wants, the INFP is able to understand its boundaries, understand it, the standards, and able to not break those boundaries and standards and remain loyal to the INFJ. That's why they can be in a relationship. Also, it gives the INFJ the freedom. Like, let's say that it was time to initiate some bedroom activity, if you know what I mean. The INFJ, because the INFP is so comfortable, SI comfortable with what the INFJ wants, the INFJ no longer has any insecurity about initiating bedroom lovemaking. So the INFJ is just actually going to go ahead and initiate lovemaking, and to which the INFP can respond. So the initiation comes through SE because of NI wants to. I want to give you an experience in the bedroom. INFP, great, I would love to receive that experience from you because I can see you want to do that to me. Awesome. And then they have an excellent time in the bedroom together, because that is how these cognitive functions actually work. So when these functions are synchronized and are close together, so for example, if you notice in our last model, it was directly across, but we have one under. That's okay. Extroverted intuition can consume an introverted function that is a hero. This is a parent. Parent functions like consuming fellow parents, and they like consuming heroes. They don't really necessarily like to consume child or inferior functions. There's less compatibility there. Because, for example, if this was NI child, like say it was an ISFP, NE parent doesn't like NI child because the parent is like, well, that's just a little kid and they're being immature with what they want, so why do I care, right? Whereas if it's a parent to another parent, oh, you're just as responsible with what you want as I am, okay, great. Or wow, you really know what you want. Awesome. Now there's no guessing. You're going to save the world with what you want because you want to save the world, right? The NE parent is perfectly fine. Any parent's fine with a fellow parent or with a fellow hero. And that's generally how the cognitive functions work. But as far as going down below, its status as a parent, it doesn't like it, and it ends up having less compatibility. So that would mean, like, with you, if you're an INFJ, your highest compatible types are INFPs or ENFPs. Just by default, if you're an INFJ, because your functions are either directly across from each other or they're one up. So like, you know, I know what I want, and you know what I want. I know how you feel. You know how you feel. I know what I think. You care about what I think. I want to give you a good experience, and you want to receive a good experience from me. It's like perfect compatibility, and that's literally NFPs and NFJs, right? That's how compatibility works. Now, granted, there are some types out there that go outside of that model, and they are able to get through it with additional human nurture support and communication, etc. But naturally speaking, just from a type compatibility standpoint, NFJs go with NFPs. And this is an example, just from a perception function point of view, as to why that is. Introverted functions. NI users like to be consumed by NE users because they're like, oh, awesome, I just tell them what they want and they do it for me. You know, that's literally how it works. And NE users seek to give the NI users what they want. That's why they're compatible in that regard. So anyway, this video is a little bit shorter, but that's fine. I'm trying to get through these a little bit quickly and just kind of get the details out, because I really want to dive into the meat of compatibility very soon. So that's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to be trying to finish up the series today, so we'll get more of these videos out just so we have a general understanding of how these cognitive functions work and from a synchronicity standpoint. So if you found this video educational or helpful or assist you in any way, please leave a like or subscribe. If you have any questions about cognitive synchronicity, especially relating to introvert intuition or extrovert intuition, go ahead and leave it in the comment section. If you are an NE user or an NI user in a relationship with somebody, by all means, leave a little anecdote and whatnot about some things that you've stated that you've wanted or some things that you've gotten your lover that you've wanted. Just kind of give some examples for some of our viewers to understand how all that works. That would be awesome. So, great. I'll see you guys tonight.